I am Ashok Charkal, Honorary Secretary, Canarian and Charitable Trust. This trust started in the year 83. We built the Prakash Court to commemorate the winning of All England Championship by Prakash Padukone. Since then, we have been conducting tournaments, mainly state ranking tournaments, for last 30 years. And for last 10-15 years, we have been conducting 4 badminton tournaments. This year, we thought we'll conduct one tournament of under-17, under-19, which has not been conducted by anybody. Rather, very less number of tournaments were conducted. And we were also not catering to that a segment of under-17, under-19, mainly college students. We thought it would be prudent for us to have one tournament in that category. This tournament has 200 entries. And approximately the same number of matches are being played over a period of 4 days. Of course, since the number of rounds will be more, the first 2 days will be more matches. As the round progresses, the number of matches will reduce, but the duration increases because the competitiveness increases. The prize money in this tournament is 50,000. Being a 3-star tournament, we have to distribute 50,000, the total prize money. Ashwath Narayan, our MLA, Malleshwaram MLA, Honorable MLA, he will be inaugurating on 23rd morning, and Prakash Padukone himself has agreed to be the chief guest who will be distributing the prizes to the winners and the runners-up on 26th. So since this being the first tournament of 17 and 19 conducted by us on our own funds, we thought it would be prudent for us to call Prakash as the chief guest, and it was nice of him to agree to be a chief guest. Another addition is the semi-finalist also will be getting the prize money only in singles and double, only in singles. So under 17 boys singles, boys double and girls singles will be getting the prize share apart from the winners and runners of 17 and 19. We do have doubles, so total number of 8 events we have in boys and girls. So 26th will have morning, will have semi-finals, evening will have finals.
And you will be awarding the prizes on 27th.
No, 26th evening. 26th evening will be awarding the prizes. The uniqueness is we being the unlike any other major clubs, we are not dependent on any sponsors for this tournament, and we are conducting out of own funds with no profit, no loss motive. Whatever is earned from the badminton, our activities are only badminton. We rent out the courts, we earn it from the members, that is flowed back to the badminton. So the flow back is in by way of conducting tournaments. We also give out the courts at a concessional rates to educational institutions, and some of the trusts who are physically challenged children, we give them at a free of cost. And to table tennis, our sister concern Canara Union conducts a state tournament for table tennis. We give this hall without charging anything to them. So we are into sports in general, badminton in particular. Anything for badminton, we are ready to do for. See, we have under 13, under 15 tournament. That is then apart from that, that is seniors tournament, that's for men's and women's. And then inter-school, Bangalore. This inter-school tournament is an interesting thing. Inter-school tournament is we conduct for under 10, under 12, under 14 and under 16 category, for 4 categories. This was a brainchild of Ramesh Padukone, late Ramesh Padukone, father of Prakash Padukone. So Prakash supports that tournament in all ways. We support it by giving the court and our manpower. But otherwise, it is Prakash's, that's why we named the tournament after late Ramesh Padukone. for in that is conducted every year in November.
These tournaments from the last how many years you are conducting?
Inter-school and the men's tournament we have been conducting for last 30 years. Under 13 is for last 15 years. Under 13 and under 15.
And 17 to 19 years, this is the first time you are conducting?
Yeah, this is the first time we are conducting 17 to 19 years. We had first time in the sense CUCT on its own. Otherwise, there was once a few times based on the contributions made by badminton lovers, we have conducted it. But first time in the sense that CUCT on its own, we have conducted the tournament. We are conducting the tournament.
So totally, how many matches you told?
200 matches.
200 matches. And winners, runners and semi-finalists, so you are recognizing.
That's only in singles semi-finalists will get. Okay. Doubles, because there are a number of people more, we give it only to winners and runners up. But singles up to semi-finalists, whoever comes, they will get their share of.
Okay. So what are your future plans for the next year? So you are going to continue this 17, 19 years?
We will continue, but if there are any sponsors, we welcome them in the interest of badminton. If there are any sponsors who want to help us in conducting the tournament, we welcome that. We would be interested in getting touch with them.
So if any schools, colleges, so if they are interested for inter-school events, so will you help them, sir? So
definitely,
through your
definitely,
trust,
definitely.
Are conducting the tournaments through your trust?
We it is on our minds. It's in the pipeline. We are contacting the government schools to spot the talent at government schools, because government schools we see the mostly underprivileged people would be going, and they would be lacking in facility. So we are getting in touch with the right authorities to tap the talent there. To quote, in inter-school a year back, there was one student, Saif Ali. We had helped him. He won the tournament. He was also given a scholarship of a promising youngster. And we came to know that he was not able to pay his fees. We had helped him pay his fees also. This is one of our, it is in our annual report, and we have done it in the past. We would like to continue it in a bigger way.
So do you have any plans for only for government inter-school tournaments to conduct, if any sponsors are ready for that?
Yeah, definitely. Now, why not? We can do it if only for government schools. If anybody is willing to come forward, our doors are open to them. For the courts are there.
Whether it is for government school or for private schools.
That is any inter school is anyway it is there. Prakash is helping us in that. If it is anybody, corporates want to come forward to help us to conduct only government schools. Yes, we are ready for it.
Okay, if they are willing, so then how they should contact you, sir?
Email ID is prakashcoats@rediffmail.com, or our phone number 2331-7980, or they can contact me personally also, 9845-116-996. Email would be fine. We can give a well-thought-out proposal to them. Apart from the inter-school tournament for government, we have a few tournaments in our mind, but due to lack of funds, which we are not able to do it. One is a corporate tournament, and another is a inter-club tournament. We would like to invite all the clubs in Bangalore, all the corporates, major corporates in Bangalore, and conduct a tournament specially for them. But if any corporate who are willing to help us in conducting financially, yes, we would be willing to conduct that tournament.
Inter-corporate
or inter-club, we are willing to do that. Our doors are always open, our court is there, we have the expertise to conduct. We can do it at a much lesser cost than any of the event managers here. We have a coaching program for children, which is as I said, ours, we charge very less amount, I can say we charge coaching fees on a quarterly basis. What we charge quarterly, many of them charge for a month. So that way we are contributing to the residents in and around Malleshwaram. There are few residents who are coming from far away because of good coaches available with us. This is we are concentrating only for the age group of 18 to 13 because that's where the talent lies and they are the future of India. And our charges for the corporates for booking also is very competitive. We are the least, we charge the least compared to any of the clubs in Bangalore. So we being no profit, no loss organization, we are not commercialized. Ours is only service motive in development of badminton. So.
And you are located at the heart of the center.
Yeah, Malleshwaram is a heart of city. But we have not promoted ourselves to an extent which we should have. We feel by now we should have. We through this tournament, we are definitely putting ourselves in the market, so that we can help the sport compete with cricket. Why I say cricket is. Cricket is the most popular game in India, and badminton comparatively was not that much. Of course, off late because of Saina Nehwal and Srikanth Kidambi and some of the few after beating Chinese players, the game has picked up, the popularity has picked up. The whole credit for the whole credit of picking up the credit for the badminton coming up is because of Prakash. Prakash put, I always say, Prakash put India on the badminton map of the world and badminton on the Indian map. But after that, after Prakash, there was a big void in India. Of course, now it has been filled. Indians are performing, Indians are seen as a threat to Chinese supremacy. Seeing all this, I said yes, badminton would be a competitor to cricket. There is a choice for the people who want to get into individual sport and perform on their own merit.
So in the different categories of sports, badminton, it has to come into the mainstream also.
Yeah.
That's what I mean.
It has to, it's already come and it has to...
Still more people has
more,
to...
More people have to come in.
Get,
if I see the number of applicants, I see the for coaching, badminton has picked up in last decade. It has to come up more so that... we have better players.
So even in India and Karnataka, any state you take, people are playing badminton in streets, even in the house corridor. So it is so popular.
Yeah, that's one beauty of badminton is
wherever it can be.
It can be played wherever. When you are playing cricket, there's a fear of breaking glass panes, but window panes, but not in badminton. You can start off anytime you like. But if you want to get into competitive, you come to us. We will help you do that.